Natural language processing, or NLP, is a specialized field within machine learning focused on interpreting and processing human language, or natural language. This is crucial, as only a fraction of the population knows a computer language. So we need algorithms capable of communicating and interacting with people in their native languages. NLP acts as a bridge, giving machines the ability to read, understand, and respond in a more human-like manner. NLP is used in a wide range of applications, from language translation and speech recognition to large language models, like those powering ChatGPT. Today, we will explore a fundamental component of NLP, text preprocessing. When building and using an AI model, you need to give it information in a form it can understand. This usually involves transforming the input data into a structured format, which reduces the amount of work for the model to learn and make predictions. This step in data preparation is known as preprocessing. When working with images, for example, preprocessing might involve resizing the images to fit within a certain region. For audio signals, preprocessing could include filtering out noise or adjusting the volume to a standard level. In the case of NLP models, preprocessing takes many forms, depending on the language and purpose of the model. Given a piece of text, you may prepare it by removing all unnecessary whitespace, punctuation, common words, or special characters. This reduces the complexity of the text and can improve the efficiency of the language model. Let's explore some of the more common text preprocessing operations. To make the examples easy to read and understand, we will use Mathematica. Speaking of Mathematica, did you know we have an online course on the essentials of Mathematica? It's true. And now you know it's true. For our sample text, we'll use the following excerpt from the short story, The Eyes Have It, by Philip K. Dick. I read on, and came to this incredible revelation, tossed off coolly by the author without the faintest tremor. Outside the movie theater, we split up. Part of us went inside, part over to the cafe for dinner. Binary fission, obviously, splitting in half and forming two entities. Probably each lower half went to the cafe, it being farther, and the upper halves to the movies. I read on, hands shaking. A common preprocessing step is to divide the text into a list of words. This is called tokenization. In the Wolfram language, the built-in function textwords will do this. Notice that the list does not contain any punctuation. No colons, commas, periods, quotes, or ellipses. It's just a sequence of words. This is part of what makes tokenization an important preprocessing step. It simplifies text to its core components, words. By the way, we use the term tokenization because there are times when elements beyond words, such as phrases or individual characters, become the fundamental units for analysis. For this reason, we'll call the individual elements of this list tokens instead of words. As you scan your eyes over this list of tokens, you'll notice that some words are capitalized and others are not. Another common step is to replace all characters with lowercase characters. In the Wolfram language, you can do this with the toLowercase function. The process of taking data and putting it into a standard form is called normalization. So one fancy way to describe this step is case normalization. Again, this step helps to reduce complexity in text and make data more uniform. In natural language, not all words carry the same amount of information. Consider this five-word sentence. I ate pizza for dinner. Which word is more essential? Pizza or four? If you look at what remains when you remove each word, you get two fragments. I ate for dinner and I ate pizza dinner. In both cases, you can tell that I ate dinner, but only in the second case can you tell what was eaten. This is the idea behind stop words. commonly used words that are filtered out of text because they carry little information. The word stop is used because common words are stopped from being passed on to the NLP model. In Mathematica, we can test this idea with the delete stop words function. If you compare the number of tokens before and after we remove the stop words, you can see that 35 words were removed. We can examine which words were removed by using the complement function. Complement is a commonly used and very useful operation when working with sets. Another technique for pre-processing text is replacing words with a standardized representative from a group of similar words. For example, consider the three related words motivate, motivation, and motivational. If all three words were used in a piece of text, they would be treated as separate words. But conceptually, they are highly related. So through a technique called stemming, you can remove common prefixes and suffixes to get a more common kernel. With Mathematica, we can do this with the wordstem function. If we use this function on these three related words, the result is the same word fragment. When you use stemming, the result does not have to be an actual word. The stem for each word is just a subset of the letters that captures the heart of the word. To see this, let's return to our text example. Here is our current list of words, or tokens. Let's use the function wordstem on this list. As you can see, some words are changed and others are not. Let's visualize this another way by using the tableform function, with the before and after list of tokens. Now we can scroll through to see which words were shortened and which were not. An alternative technique is called lemmatization. Here you replace each word with a standard representative for a cluster of closely related words. So if you used lemmatization on the words motivate, motivation, and motivational, they might all be replaced with motivate, an actual related word, and not a substring. The Wolfram language does not have a built-in lemmatization function, but you will find one in many natural language processing toolkits. We've seen some of the key pre-processing techniques used in NLP, tokenization, case normalization, removing stop words, and stemming. But remember, there are many other functions available. You can find more details about the built-in natural language processing functions in Mathematica on the Wolfram Documentation Center. The more you work with natural language processing, the more you will encounter these and other pre-processing tools. And be sure to visit our website, socratica.com, to check out our current and upcoming courses on AI and machine learning.